buy anything on the internet because they are not, number one, licensed to sell alcohol. Number two, you never know where it comes from because it's very easy to counterfeit these bottles. I mean, that, eBay, you see a bottle on eBay, there are these stories that our number, some of our bottles were numbered. Okay, there's 23-year-old. It's got number C41 on there, and all of a sudden it's full the next week. How did they fill that bottle up with the same label number? So it's pretty obvious. Y'all ever heard of something called funneling? It's illegal. It's where you buy a bottle of really nice whiskey, then you sell it all, then you go fill it up with something else that's not quite as fine.
I noticed that the very first time I ever had a drink with Preston, Preston immediately just kind of grabs the bottle. We're all having a great time. We're drinking. He grabs it and he just pulls a key out of his pocket, and he pretty much just kind of scores across the label, and it's pretty much to make sure that that bottle doesn't get back out there and gets filled with something else. So I actually have picked up that even with my bottles at home. I immediately went through and scored them if I ever empty them, which I don't know when it'll be, but if I ever get there, they won't be filled.
Blowtorch? Who did that? Ryan did.
Yeah. Blowtorch?
Just a head little Instagram thing. They're so damn good, you can't break them.
We'll get requests more than once a week at Buffalo Trace on verifying Pappy bottles or verifying Weller bottles or antique collection and what have you, and we find a lot of fakes.
Well, you'd say it's probably one of the most counterfeited bottles in the world.
It's a $1 million deal out there.